With Doubtnut, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry, and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question, and get instant video solution. Download Doubtnut app today.
Hello students, the question is asking that primary alkyl halide, that's C4H9Br, A, reacted with alcoholic KOH to give a compound B. Means this reacting, if this is reacting with alcoholic KOH, in that conditions alkyl will be formed. But B is reacted with the HBr to give C, and which is an isomer of A. That means here the another HBr will be formed, but that another alkyl that will be formed, but that is the isomer of the compound A that is already given. When A is reacted with the sodium metal, it gives a compound C4H18, which is different from the compound when n-butyl bromide, a normal butyl bromide, is treated with sodium metal. Give the structure of A and write the equation of all the reaction. First of all, this cannot be a normal butyl, because normal butyl bromide is reacting with the sodium, then this will give this compound. So that means this is not a normal butyl bromide, but this is clearly that this is your 1 degree bromide. So this is a primary bromide, so that conditions if this carbon will be connected by a single carbon. Now this carbon will be connected in that way, because this will be not a normal butyl. It is already written that the compound which is formed is here is different from the compound which is formed from a normal butyl bromide. So this will be the compound A. Now this is reacting with alcoholic KOH. So alcoholic KOH is a strong base. In that conditions, alkene will be formed directly without any arrangement. So alkene will be formed as this one. Means here Br will be removed and here H will be removed. So in that conditions, this alkene will be formed as CH2, and here we have this CH3. This is a compound B. That compound B reacting with the compound, reagent HBr. So what will happen according to Doubtnut formula, this reaction will happen. So more electron negative, more hydrogen. The carbon which has more hydrogen, that will attached with the hydrogen. So here one hydrogen will be attached, so it will convert into CH3. And the carbon which has less number of hydrogen, that will attack nucleophile, that is Br. So that this compound will be formed, that is a isomer of the compound A. So this is the compound B, compound C, not B. This is a compound C. Compound C. After that, this compound C is reacting with the sodium metal. When A is reacting with the, C is completed here. Now A is reacting with the sodium metal, which gives a compound B, and that is C8H18. So this compound will react with this A. So this can be written as in that way, like CH3CH, after that CH3CH2Br. And that will be reacting with the sodium. Two moles of sodium we have to take, and in that condition write this compound in opposite direction, so that we can form, basically this is your original reaction. So from here what will happen, this will be converted into NEBR. This NEBR will be released, and the product will form as this one, this compound D, CH3CH. Here we have this CH3, after that CH2, 4 carbon, after that again CH2, CH and CH3, and in this carbon CH we have this one more CH3. So this is the compound B. So this is the complete solution. I hope you understood this concept. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITG and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubtnut app today.